Good morning, church. Welcome to our daily devotion insight. Today, I want to share with you a devotion on God is at work in the most dire of circumstances. The story about Queen Esther. I want you to follow me as I read. Esther 4, verse 14. Even if you remain silent in this at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place. But you and your father's family will perish. And who knows but that you have come to a royal position for such a time as this. It is difficult for us today to imagine the fear and insecurity that would have pledged Queen Esther, chosen solely on the basis of her beauty and appeal to the king. You know, Esther was no princess with the clout of her father's kingdom to enhance her position in the court. She, you know, when she was summoned, you know, not summoned for 30 days, she did not know, you know, as if the king had found someone more pleasing or she's merely losing her influence. You know, since she was appointed in, she as the new queen, she was never asked for by the king for 30 days. As a dispatched orphan Jew, Esther has been reared by Mordecai, an older relative. Whether at his bidding, by force of evil officials, or by her own choice, Esther had entered the king's beauty contest and won. Amazing. Now Mordecai's sources inform Esther that the Jewish people were scheduled for extinction by the wicked Haman, a self-promoter who had elevated himself to wise regent, second only to the monarch King Xerxes. Faced with a desperate challenge of survival for herself and her people, the Bible tells me Esther pondered Mordecai's question. The question is this: who knows but that you have come to your royal position for such a time as this? Three principles are embodied in Mordecai's advice to Esther. Listen with me. One, no place of privilege can ever exempt a person from responsibility to respond to God's call. What it means is this: no matter how high our position is or how low our position is, how wealthy and how unwealthy we are, you know what? No one can avoid the responsibility to respond to God's call upon our life. If God has called you to do something, to stand in the gap, to pray for someone, to give, to be brave, to come to church, to worship God, to serve Him and to do something, you know what? Obey it. Number two, the second principle. Although a situation may look hopeless, God is never helpless. No matter how bad, how big our problem may be, the circumstances, the situation may be, you know, and look hopeless, God is never helpless because He is almighty. He is still on the throne. He can do great things. Number three, a God-given opportunity is an individual's received privilege. One more time. A God-given opportunity is an individual's received privilege. If God gives you an opportunity to do what He wants you tonight to do, you know what? It's a privilege that you have received. Do something about it. Do something about it. That's what it means. You know, courageously with this advice, Esther formulated her plan to help her people, even if it meant the real possibility that she might be killed in the effort of helping her people. So she prepared herself, both physically as well as spiritually. Why? The Bible tells us she fasted in Esther chapter 4, verse 16, chapter 9, verse 31. Then, seizing the right moment, Esther presented her case to the king, not questioning the king's justice or righteousness, but humbly asking for mercy for herself and for the people. That's what she did. Divine guidance seemingly directed Esther's words, thoughts, and action. One more time. Words, thoughts, and action. God directed her. She had won the respect and the ear of her royal husband, the king, Xerxes. And in response, the king assigned Esther the task of rewriting the law, making her the heroine of her people. Esther chapter 9, verse 29 said this. So Queen Esther, daughter of Abihail, along with Mordecai the Jew, wrote with full authority to confirm this second letter concerning Purim. You know, even when God seems distant, absent, He is still at work. One more time. Even when God seems distant, absent, He is still at work. Even though whatever needs and struggle and difficulty you are going through, a struggle and situation and circumstances you are facing and going through, all the pain and sicknesses you are going through, you know what? You have been praying, maybe trusting God and trusting God and trusting God, and sometimes even God seems to be so far away, distant, and absent, don't seem to be answering our prayer. You know what? From Esther's case, from Esther's story, and Esther's life, and what Esther did, the Bible tells us what? God is still at work behind the scene. Esther is a reminder to us today of God's sovereignty. God used her beauty. God used her intelligence. Perhaps even her respectful attitude toward her husband, as well as her remarkable, fearless faith to accomplish God's will, to do what God wants her to do. She's not afraid, even though it cost her life. She's not afraid because you know why? Her people's life are far more important than her. Hey, some of us don't come to church. Some of us are afraid to come to church. We are afraid of this, afraid of that. You know what? God is still at work behind the scene. When you dare to come forward and worship God and come together to serve God, come together to do what God wants you not to do, you know what? God can do the impossible beyond yours and my comprehension. Amen. Amen. Through her obedience, the Bible says, Esther became a true star, you know, and in the kingdom, the Persian kingdom. Amen. Now, let me close with this. Does a situation in your life seem hopeless, sickness, disease, financial, occupational, what else? COVID-19, a misunderstanding between you and your spouse, or a broken relationship between your boyfriend or your girlfriend, or something bad happened and it caused a severe pain and hurt in your life, whatever it may be. Does the situation in your life seem hopeless? Remember, God is not helpless. One more time. God is not helpless. If you are in a position of privilege, ask God to give you the courage to respond to His call to action. One more time. If you are in a position of privilege, if God tells you, hey, go, hey, do something, hey, serve, serve me, serve Him. Ask God, if you receive the position of privilege, ask God to give you the courage to respond to His call to action. Serve God. Amen? Amen? Let's pray. Father, we ask for your blessing upon all who listen to your word. May you strengthen, renew, and refresh us. Bless us with a great, great day. This we pray and ask in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen? So what is it all about? God is at work in the most dire circumstances of our life. He is working behind the scene. All you and I need to do is to trust Him. Amen. You have a great day and God bless you.